All right, this is looking pretty good. I'm not too happy with the background color, right? If you're in light mode, then you get a white background color. If you're in dark mode, you get a black background color. I kind of want to customize my background color. And if you saw what I did in the last section, which was I added a dot background modifier to my text, and you saw that I could add modifiers to my stacks, you might be thinking, oh, right? How I add a background color to my entire app is I'm going to go to my H stack right here. Okay, again, let's tap on the curly brace so that you know where it ends. And let's tap at the end of the curly brace and let's add a dot background, right? So there's a certain number of colors you can use and you can scroll through these to see them, right? Dot black, dot blue, dot cyan, and various other things. So I'm going to choose dot teal, which is a nice little background color. But now I'm a little bit disappointed because, as you can see, my background does not actually cover the entire screen. And why is that? Well, that's because of the way views are laid out in SwiftUI. Many views actually take up only as much space as they need. They're called fitting views. I'm sure you've worn some fitting clothes before when, you know, you've outgrown some clothes or you've eaten too much Nutella, which I do every now and then. And you try and wear some of your old clothes, you'll find that, oh, right, these are very fitting, right? They take up as much space as necessary. So all these V stacks and H stacks are actually fitting views. They only take up as much space as their contents require. We've actually seen something called a filling view, right? A filling view is something that takes up as much space as it can. And that was the image. Remember when we first imported our image, it took up as much space as possible, right? That's because it was trying to fill the entire screen and we brought it down to a fixed size by using resizable. So what we need to do is we need to add in a filling background color to our app. And the way we do that is by using something called a Z stack. Okay, so H stack, horizontal, V stack, vertical, Z stack, back to front. I'm just gesticulating at the screen a bit. Okay. So the way a Z-stack works, let me just draw on the screen a little bit, is we actually want something that's behind all this. So here's our Z-stack, followed by our H-stack. And what we can do is we can color this Z-stack whatever color we want with something that fills the entire screen. Okay, so let's do that. First, let's get rid of this background color over here. Not to worry, it'll come back soon. Soon, that's me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap above my H stack. I'm going to go create a Z stack. Oh, wait, I realized I shouldn't call it Z stack because I don't like the way the Americans spell and pronounce things. Z stack it is. Z stack. So Z stack, open curly brace. And as always, you type in open curly brace, you get the close curly brace. But some of you might type really quickly. You type open curly brace, close curly brace. You're not going to get two curly braces. It will be smart and it'll just overwrite the current curly brace. So that's nice. Go back inside here, press enter. And now you have to make sure that your Z stack contains your H stack. Okay, you have to make sure that your Z stack contains your H stack. So once again, there are two ways to do this. You could cut the H stack code by selecting it, or you can try dragging the handles of the closing curly brace. So that's like taking an alligator and saying, open your mouth wide, and then stuffing something inside it, okay? I'm going to give that a try. It gets a little bit wonky when you do it with a lot of code, but let's try it out because it really is kind of fun to see the animations. So let's give it a shot. I tap on this and drag. Drag, 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 drag. Okay, so a little bit. Okay, so the danger of this is that you might end up letting go at some random place and your curly brace does not encompass everything that it should. So be very careful when doing something like this, right? I think our best bet is to actually do it with the cut and paste method. So I'm going to undo Command Z, and I'm going to go select my H stack. I'm going to select this text and drag it all the way down to the end of the H stack, including the closing curly brace. How do I know that I've selected the entire H stack? Well, you probably want to tap on the curly brace one time. Just keep an eye on where the closing curly brace is. The closing curly brace should be nicely aligned to the start of the word H stack. And at this point, if you press cut, I think you'll do something weird. It might actually only cut part of it, okay, leaving the word HStack. So don't do that. Let's undo. Right, instead, select the part of the code that you do want to cut. Right, so HStack. Okay, this looks fine. Let's cut it and let's paste it inside here. Okay, so this is a little bit challenging, right? Just be careful that you get it right. And this is what your code should look like when you're done, right? So a ZStack followed by an HStack. Okay, so ZStack here, HStack here. And everything is nicely aligned, okay? So remember, we wanted something else behind the HStack. We wanted a background color. Just so happens that you can just type in color, American spelling, color.teal. And color is a filling view. It will fill whatever space it can. So that's great. It fills up all the background. And then you place your HStack on top of it. Okay? Some of you might be wondering, what if I don't like the built-in colors? Well, you can do color dot. And you can go and take a look at some of these init functions. I won't go into too much detail. But maybe you can go online and find out more about how to make custom colors. But for now, I'm pretty happy with all these built-in ones. I'm gonna choose color.mint. Ooh, very nice. Okay, now that I have this nice mint color in the background, what if I really want another color behind my HStack? So let's try that. So let's see where the HStack ends. That's kind of tough. So remember, we tap on the opening curly brace for the HStack, right? And we know where it is. Let's go down here and type dot background. And I'm gonna type in dot teal. Right, dot teal, slightly different from dot mint. Okay, so this hopefully helps you appreciate how the different background colors and the ZStack works together. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to also try showing you this, where instead of background, just dot teal, I'm going to type in color dot teal. This makes absolutely no difference. Okay, so when you're working with enums, you might notice that at some times you can actually drop the word before the dot. However, I can't actually type ZStack and dot mint over here. That will give us an error, right? You'll say, cannot infer contextual based in reference to member mint, right? That's, who knows what that means, right? So just be aware, right, that sometimes you can drop the word before the dot in the enum, right? And that's usually when it's inside the brackets of a modifier. Usually, right? So you can see all these times we're in the modifier. Very often, we don't need the word before the dot. But when you're trying to create a view by itself, you are going to need the word before the enum. Okay, this looks almost decent. I think I want some padding around my entire HStack. I think you know how to do that. So I'm just going to go here. Before the background color, I'm going to add a bit of padding. All right, that's almost great, and it would kind of work if your names are not so big, right? And if you find that you need more space for your name or anything, you can adjust the font sizes. Let's go change this to 30, and that looks all right. Okay, we've come to the end of this section. I hope you learned something interesting, and if you did, please go and tell someone about it, like, you know, the person sitting right next to you in the coffee shop. Yeah, just grab them and say, oh, have you looked at this video? It's awesome. All right, don't do that. All right. Remember to like and subscribe, and I will see you at some point. Wait, I mean soon.